Hey guys, what is going on? It is Purdue here, and we are back. We got Super Bowl gameplay for you guys. I'm not going to stall long. You guys see, we have won 7 in a row, so it should be a really exciting game. I'm hoping Pouncey can get us another dub here, and let's get into it. Alrighty guys, we are in the Super Bowl, and it should be very exciting. Honestly, I was pretty nervous when I was going into this game. It was a really good one though, guys. It was competitive. You guys know, what win or lose, I show you competitive games. Even for gameplay, I'll play 4 or 5 in a row, whatever it takes, but I want to get competitive games. I don't care. There's no point in posting a 30-0 dub to you guys. And here, I will tell you guys, so you're not wasting your time, this Super Bowl is very competitive. And we are starting out with the ball first, guys. So we're going to try and hit him with a triple option straight off the bat. We're going to motion out our Eric Ebron, and we're going to try and do the triple option here. He's actually playing our gifts. We are coming out with Michael Vick, and there is no pitch key anywhere in sight. So we're able to get it with a free game with Michael Vick, and we're able to get a first down right off the bat. Coming out next in the I-form wing, guys, we're giving it. Big Ben is under center now. Like you guys have seen recently, because I've added Hot Route Master to Big Ben Roethlisberger, I go between him and Michael Vick as quarterback. Michael Vick is still a starter, and option will still forever be the main offense we run here. But when we want to go under center sometimes and I heavily want to run the ball, it's nice when people come out on these heavy man blitzes to be able to try and do Hot Route Master. There you see we had Lynn Swan open, but Michael Vick, because he takes so long to throw that ball deep, just unfortunately was not able to get the ball away in time to get a throw out of sack animation. But luckily, Lynn Swan is able to play the ball aggressively and volleyball the way so it's not intercepted. So we find ourselves now in a 4th and 8, guys, and he's coming out in this little mid-blitz that a lot of people have been running this whole meta. He's been saying pressure. He's been doing this all game. So I saw his safety on the left side was the only one who was manned up on the running back. So on the release, running back was wide open. It was a race to the edge, guys, and Reggie Bush just barely got it. But here we are again going against this mid blitz. First down, we get absolutely nothing on that power. So here we are again. Now we're in our pistol weak formation. Again, we have so many pistols, I'm trying to remember which is which. I had a bunch open there. I thought we were going to be under a lot of pressure, so that's why I got that ball out right away. I didn't realize we actually had as good protection as we did, because I would have had a lot more open deep there. I would have had Ebron, or it seemed like Claypool was about to get open. But here we are, 3rd and 5, and again, we're mixing it up. These guys, people, you don't see offense like this. I'm telling you, I know I feel like I've seen a few more people trying to run this kind of offense, and you should, because it's off meta. People are so used to bunch trips. Now Thrones dropped his strong ebook. People are going to be running stuff like that. People are not going to be knowing how to stop option football. So I'm telling you, if you get on this low-key secret wave before it becomes big in some time, option football will help you. And if you just mix in here and there, there's other read options and other playbooks or other ways you can mix in triple options that are still really good, guys. But here you're seeing we're coming out in the power option, and we're just going to try and keep this Michael Vick to the left using our fast break ability. But again, we're not able to get anything. He was either in a man blitz there, so his safeties were in man coverage playing something aggressive, or they were in QB spies. And there you see, we go for the power option, and we get tackled down the 2-yard line, guys. So this is still our first possession, first drive of the game, and we've killed it to almost a 2-minute warning, guys. That's no mistake. There's 2 minutes and 7 seconds left in this first half. He hasn't even gotten the ball yet. And on 4th and goal, I think it's our 3rd, 4th down of the drive, we punch it in with Michael Vick for the touchdown. So guys, now we're at 2-minute warning, basically, one play away from it, and he has only just gotten the ball for the first time, and we are stopping him on defense. I want to do that, guys. I want to kill this game. Like I said, squeeze it like an anaconda, drain the clock out of this game, so people are going to force big plays. They're going to try and force the need to go downfield and score quick. That is the idea. So when we get an interception, I'm just going to squeeze it that much more, because it's going to push it to a 2-score game, and now you're really struggling and suffering to go get points, and that is the whole idea of this offense. It's not scoring big points every game. It's a methodical offense, guys. Like they say, it's chess, not checkers. It's football is as much of a mental game as it is physical. If not, it's honestly more mental. Everything happens before the snap. And here we are. He's driving on us, guys. He's doing a really good job. Like I said, I want to force people into big plays. This guy's done the exact opposite. He's been a great, disciplined football player, taking his checkdowns, taking what we give him. When I try to send pressure, he's able to stay calm in the pocket, not get panicked, and he's able to hit us where we leave things open. And it's honestly killing us, but he's doing a good job. I'll give him respect. So now I'm wanting to mix it up. I'm showing like I'm going to send a bunch of pressure, but I'm dropping everyone off. And he was canning us with these curl routes, and I tried to use her with Terrell Edmonds, and he was actually going to run a deep out there. But luckily, Troy Polamalu on the acrobat, and again, he has 90 zone coverage, so he meets the I think, highest or second highest threshold because of 99. He's able to make an animation for us, guys. So on fourth down, again, I'm using Terrell, watching that curl route because that's what I was afraid of. And again, Troy Polamalu with that zone threshold and with his acrobat is able to get us an interception two plays in a row. Troy P on his own is just making plays for us, guys. So here again, we're going to triple option, pitch out to Barry Sanders, and we swerve out his user. He clicked off way too late there, and we're able to get another first down. Guys, that's how we're going to end the half. The plays after that did not lead anywhere, but I thought that was a really, really good play. That's how you want to execute a pull and pitch. If you guys want to learn more about that, especially from that Heisman formation, go check it out in the playbook, Purdue's playbook that I've dropped recently. Again, we're going to be coming with more videos like that. I think they might be like a Tuesday thing. Don't hold me to that, but I'm going to do them often. Don't worry. We're going to break down one or two formations at a time. But it was definitely a good video. So guys, keep showing support on it. I definitely like that you guys are responding to it, because the more you do that, the more it drives me to push the video out. And I've definitely seen that I should get another one out soon. But here you are, you're seeing we're playing really good defense. And guys, it's a 3rd and 10 now. We're still up 7-0. This is still a nail biter, still a one possession game. One play game, as they say. One play, and we are no longer in the lead. It's a one play game. So here we are, we gotta get a stop here. And again, I don't know what that is, but that motion, I guess, corner-ish route, I don't know, is just destroying us with Chad Johnson on the sideline. It's not even like a real corner. I don't even know what it is. I guess it is a corner, but just because I guess where he snaps it, it's such a late breaking one that it just beats our zones. It's very annoying. That's why I use our Terrell sometimes, you'll see. But I'm trying to mix it up. We still got Polamalu's X Factor, so I'm wanting to use that to my advantage. I'm going to try and do a user rush here. I believe that's what I'm setting up. But this guy was really good at picking up our user rushes. I don't know how, but his linemen obviously had great awareness and like great athleticism, because they were able to get in position to pick up Terrell Edmonds almost all the time. So when he'd block our running back, I would be picked up every time. And when I try and drop off late, the running back would be able to pick off Terrell if he somehow got through. So he knew how to set up his pass protection, guys. That's basically the end of it. So 4th and 2, we're dropping everyone back into coverage. I'm looking to play great here, but Terrell, for whatever reason, is playing a hard flat, not the curl flat that I put him in. And there you see his corner out was sitting wide open for most of that play, and he finally reads it because we couldn't get any pressure, only sending 3. And he's able to get out of the pocket and dot us there. So now, 1st down, he's just running again the power G out of this I-form wing formation. I run this formation, it's a really good power play, but I think this 3-4 defense really does shut down that power G. If you pinch your linebackers, press your defense, not baseline press, but just press normally, and then slide your D-line to the way the tight ends, and again, pinch your linebackers, I think that's how you shut down power G completely. I usually get great sheds for tackle for loss on it. And the only thing you gotta watch is I use the backside safety where the single receiver is, because you gotta watch for counters or stuff like that. But otherwise, if you guys think that's a good defensive tip. If you guys have any other ways of stopping it, please let me know. But yeah, here you are. You see, we drop full coverage again, and we actually get a ping with Minka Fitzpatrick. It's insane. We are trying to mix up the blitzes now. Sometimes I'll sub in Sam Mills at D end, and because he's so high of an overall now, I figured it actually works. I never thought about it before, but I've just started trying this. When I want to fake my blitzes, I'll sub in Sam Mills at D end and take out TJ Watt, and I'll drop him to flats and I'll only send 3 and play full coverage. And I have guys who are actually decent in zone. And I know Sam Mills is a linebacker, but still, it's a good way of mixing it out. And it's not a normal D end in coverage. It's still a decent linebacker who's high overall in zone. And there you see, we're just fitting that ball into the running back, Reggie Bush. His user, if he had acrobat, definitely would have picked that, probably even would have been a house call, but because he didn't, I definitely wanted to squeeze it in there, and I knew it was going to be open. Reggie Bush just couldn't hang on to the ball, so we are forced to punt the ball, guys. He got a decent return, and now here we are. We got to play defense again. We are in the 4th quarter, guys. 4 fingers up, please. Like, this is tense. We're still a one play game, and on the sidelines he dots us again. It is so painful. Now you guys are going to see here, he's on the right sideline, and I think it is the last play. It was looking like a cover 3 beater might be open, but our safety was playing it, so I didn't think it was going to get open. Here, I see it. I think our safety is going to keep playing this, so I go to cover the tight end again. And for whatever reason, I don't know if it was Minka or Shaquille, but they just did not cover Tyreek Hill on that post route. Very unfortunate. So here we're coming out in the read option. We're just able to escape his safety, and we're able to get a great game with Reggie Bush. Guys, we just need a field goal to win this game. We just need to drive down, do what we do. It comes down to the offense. I don't know why, but that was a horrible cut by Barry Sanders. I don't know why he stopped and pivoted so slowly. He needed to just cut up to the left. But either way, we need to figure it out. We still got a yard. Again, we're cooking it up here with Ben Roethlisberger, using that hot route master to our advantage.
This is big brain.
And there you guys see, absolute laser to Eric Ebron, the new tight end over the middle. Well, not completely new, but I like to say new because of the upgrade they gave him. He's now got 92 speed for us. That's insane. That kind of speed at tight end, I absolutely love to see it. But here we are again. We're mixing up, coming in all different gun formations he has not seen yet. So there's no way he knows what's coming. We're running RPO screens. We're doing all different things, handing this off. He has no idea what is coming, guys. We are milking this clock out. We have no timeouts. He is using his now to try and stop this clock. Seeing if he can possibly get the ball back. We're on conservative carrying, though, not risking a fumble. That's why I'm Barry Sanders. We don't juke there. You see, we're not able to get the first down. But on 3rd and 11, we're able to run this read option again, the one that burnt him for the touchdown earlier in the game. And we're able to get the first down with it. Why? Because there's no read key, like I always say, guys. So here we're going to spike the ball, and it's up to the field goal. I'll leave y'all with it.
Possessed through the drama.
And H is for the hurt, distance. But it's all into for the honor.
A is for my attitude, working through the patience. Hey. Money comes and goes, so the M is for motivation. Hey. Gotta stay consistent, the P is to persevere. The I is for integrity, innovative career. The O is optimistic, open and never shut. And the N is necessary, cause I'm never giving up. See, they ask me how I did it, I just did it from the heart. Crushing the competition, been doing it from the start. They say that every champion is all about his principles. Carry. Champions are made of.